It's the newest stadium on the NFL landscape, and it might just be the grandest as you get a look at SoFi Stadium here in Inglewood.
Straight ahead, it's a matchup of unbeatens between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Los Angeles Chargers.
Michael Badgley set to kick off.
Certainly the game of the weekend, maybe the game of the year, the battle of the unbeatens as we get underway.
Now this will make it into the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
Their own 16-yard line.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10.
And now the Bengal defense here calling a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10.
Here's the first carry for Austin Ekeler. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
Taken in by his running back. And they work this well upfield across the 45. The end result, 21 yards.
First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
A shotgun throw for Stick. Escaping the pressure right. He's going to take off with it. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive gain. On second down, Ekeler. Only a yard of the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instinct. Being able to diagnose run or pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play. Stick from the gun. Now he's flushed out right. It's incomplete, broken up. But there is a flag down. Let's see what that's about. Thought they were going to force a fourth down. Instead, P.I. gives them the first.
And that's frustrating because you think you've taken them really deep into the count, haven't you? Instead, you've got to start all over. That can really, really be demoralizing.
It's a gain of 11 and a first down, L.A.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
Almost able to intercept it. That's one he would have liked to have held on to on his first drive. Instead, second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Out of the gun, Ekeler running it. And only a yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26.
DJ Reader.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Flush to his right. And that'll bring up fourth down as his Cincy defense stands up on third.
The keeper. Thrown away and incomplete.
Randy Bullock now as he'll go for the field goal. On the right hash, it's a 43-yard attempt. Bullock's kick is good. And the Chargers grab themselves a 3-0 lead. So the opening drive does yield points, maybe not the seven they wanted, but they'll take the three.
Accumulating first downs does not go up on the scoreboard, but it does go into the DNA of a team that's trying to establish itself to start a game. That has to feel pretty good for them. They'll take the three.
Yeah, they have three first downs and 3 points.
At their own 25-yard line.
Burrow and the Bengals with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
On first and 10, Joe Burrow eluding the pressure right. They'll try and run it. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46.
Now that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
First carry for the former Oklahoma Sooner, Joe Mixon. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think they had three tight ends in on that sack.
And these guys are punching really well. I use boxing analogies a lot. A lot of coaches have told me that when you line up to run the football, it's 10 fist fights along the line of scrimmage, right? You've got to win your share. These three tight ends, they almost always win their fist fights.
And now he'll tuck it and run. And he'll be taken down at the 34. Give him three on the keeper there, and it is second down.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up three on that carry.
And now they will throw it with Burrow. He's going to have the hook up to Ross. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
On third and 1, Burrow. He finds his running back, Mixon. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. The defense surrenders a 13-yard pass play there on third and 1.
And a Bengal first down.
From the red zone now, here's Burrow first down. And he is going to go down. They sack him on the final play of the first quarter. 3-0 after 1 on EA Sports. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. The gun, it's Burrow. Flushed out right. But now he's going to use his legs. He'll wind up getting four there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation.
A gain of four, and it's third down.
Passing here, Joe Burrow. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked up. And he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at him. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
And able to get it across the 20 before they get to it. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. But as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Escaping the pressure right. He'll run it. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be second down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Stick looking to throw on first and 10. That's caught by Kellen. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 14 yards is the pickup there, and a Charger first down.
First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Running on first down, Eckler. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
Chargers, first down. First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They'll let the QB keep it here off the option. Yeah, he's out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 11 more on that one, and another first down. Pretty ideal right there. Keep it yourself, get the first down, and get the heck out of bounds.
And knowing him, I believe he's thinking, I'd get a few more yards if I just lower my shoulder. But he also hears that second voice in his head, his head coach, probably his agent too, saying, get out of bounds, man. Don't do that.
Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
On second and 10, it's Stick. Flush to his right. And it's incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions. Third down here in 10, but you're still in field goal range.
And that's the thing to keep in mind. They're in field goal range. So now you don't take any unnecessary risks, but you try and find a way to get back to what you were doing earlier in the drive in order to finish this one off.
And that's not nearly going to be enough. Stopped at the 22, and he needed plenty more. He did his best to just get four out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down. And Bullock will put this one through. And they're able to double their lead in this first half. It's 6-0. So scores on their first two possessions, but 6-0, so field goals probably not what they were hoping for.
Hey, you're exactly right about that. Not what they were hoping for, but they should be happy that they have points on the board. It almost feels like that old slow and steady wins the race, doesn't it? In this case, though, they want to be slow and steady now, but get explosive later and put the points up on the board.
The Bengals drive about to get going.
And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in a good spot, great place to run some of your best offense. Instead, they turn the ball over.
Yeah, turn the ball over last time. See if they can avoid doing it here.
And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. Second and six, just inside the 30. Now a handoff looking right.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line.
That one, a first down pickup of 8.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
Stepping up, he's going to keep it. That one good for 15, and the Bengals get a first down.
A gain of 15. First down.
Stepping up, he'll try and run. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Burrow. He'll find his running back, Joe Mixon. Not able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2.
Complete to Joe
that
Mixon.
One nearly 30 yards, 29 officially.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open just a little underneath.
And he is in. Touchdown, Bengals. A great effort there. As the first half is winding down. And the Bengals draw even. And, of course, they can take the lead if they hit the extra point.
His kick is
and good. He's able to put it through.
Makes the score Bengals 7, Chargers 6.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. Ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
At their own 23-yard line.
The Charger drive about to get going. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. They'll throw now on the final play. And he's going to keep it here. So we're at halftime with our score 7-6 in a tough-fought first half. As we send you to our EA Studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Time long, set to kick off.
The Bengals set to receive. They have the lead and the football to begin quarter number 3. Taken in the end zone. And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback. The Bengals drive about to get going.
We have not seen much on offense from either side. These last few drives, it has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to, and if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now.
On second down, Burrow. Throw here's incomplete.
Certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
On third down, Burrow. Complete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
On is the punt team now as this one sent away. That's pulled in at the 32. Take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A very good return that time. 18 yards. And the Chargers will be set up pretty well as they take over in great field position. They'll run out of the gun with Eckler. And they'll get him down here at about the 42. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up second and 2.
Off play action, it's Stick. Now he steps away. He's going to take off with it. Comes out, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same. Give him 7 on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. On the ground, it's Eckler. And he'll get a little over 2, maybe a full 3 down to the 32-yard line. The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier. When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because there should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. A hot route, so to speak.
A nice little screen. They get 6 on first down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Stick, eluding the pressure right. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's 3rd down.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force him.
And he can't get rid of it, and he's taken down. You go 5 wide like they just did there, you can't really max protect, can you?
No, you cannot. What you're hoping is that by going 5 wide, you're forcing the defense into coverage. And if you do that, you get a chance to find some people downfield. But if they audible themselves and go into a blitz, then it's got to happen right now.
Or very lights quickly, out.
Or exactly right. Turn them out. That play's over.
Long converted the field goal. Now he handles the kickoff duties. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him 3 more.
28-yard line.
The Bengals drive about to get going. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it 1st and 10. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
He's brought down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
On 2nd down, here's Burrow. He gets this in the hands of Mixon. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. 15 yards on the play, 1st down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
First down, here's Burrow.
Going deep downfield for Ross. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Michael Davis. And the return will stop right around the 25.
CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
Here's Eckler to begin the drive. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35.
10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
First and 10 at the 35-yard line.
Here's Stick looking to throw. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really.
Now a pass dumped off to his running back. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down. Stick looks to throw. Open target here, Darius Slayton. And he can only manage to take the football to the 40, and that is well shy of the first down marker.
Time long in punt formation.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports.
Bengals 7.
On is the punter long here as he sends this one away. And it's taken in at the 9. And that'll be a return of 12 following a very nice punt. And the Bengals will take over here first and 10. The Bengals drive about to get going. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up.
At the 21-yard line.
Now Burrow. They'll set up the screen here to Mixon. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line.
This defense has certainly had an outstanding second half, haven't they? I know they just gave up a first down there, and for the offense, they're hoping that that's something that they can jumpstart with and maybe start to move the ball a little bit better. But it's been tough sledding for them here the entire second half.
We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on first and 10. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Only a yard on the keeper, and it'll be second down.
Well, partner, I don't think it's any secret that any running back wants to be able to see a hole open so that he can gallop through it. But in this case, he had to slow down. There was really no hole there. And he took a big hit in order to get that 1 yard.
Intercepted yet again. It's Chris Harrison. And they'll be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20.
Boy, so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him, let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. Obi Melifonwu with the tackle. The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5.
2nd and 5.
Stick back to pass. Forced out to his left. Now he'll pull it down. 5 yards on the scramble, and that's enough to pick up the first.
How many times have we seen this late in the fourth quarter? Because you know the pass rush is getting after him, and they get upfield, get that great push, and what do they create? Space, and he takes off.
And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd and goal.
2nd and goal at the 8-yard line.
Now Stick. On the screen, this is Eckler. And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown.
Austin Ekeler. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Chargers capitalize on the short field as they take it in for six.
And that touchdown ends a streak, for lack of a better word, of three field goals that they put on the board previously. They finally cracked the code.
Yeah, they've been down there. They've been in enemy territory, as you said. They just haven't been able to punch it in until that point. Long now will kick it away following the touchdown. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
Their own 25-yard line.
The Bengals drive about to get going. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by two scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical. Now they try the right side here. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10. At the 20.
Now Burrow to throw on second down. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. So now it's third and long, because remember, they also lose a down on the grounding call. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. He's going deep for Brown. Oh, he almost intercepted it. They're just forcing it into too many tough spots. That was almost a fourth pick of the game. And now fourth down. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. They'll try and throw forward with Burrow. Going deep downfield for Ross. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Casey Hayward. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. Seven picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offense coordinator, the quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself caught.
It's Ekeler again. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line.
And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, partner. And there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here if they have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big third down. I'd put the word big in capital letters here. Now, this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here. Stick from the gun. Buying time to his left. But I think the ball's out. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. He'll wind up getting 4 yards there on his own, but it also brings up fourth down. Here's Ty Long now. He'll boot it away from about his 35. He'll get off a fairly short kick here as this is toward the sideline. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line.
Their own 22-yard line.
The Bengals drive about to get going. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm.
Chargers able to get the pressure and bring him down. Credit the sack to Joey Bosa. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Now a dump off here complete. And he'll take this across the 25 before going out of bounds. A nice pick up there, 19 yards. And they're set up better for third.
But it's third down.
Now it's Burrow. He's got his man. It's Butler. And he is going to have a Bengals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Here we go with Burrow. He finds his running back, Mixon.
That catch good for only a couple. So second and eight here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down.
Brings up second.
Throwing now is Joe Burrow. And Burrow going to be hit and taken down. They got him. Linval Joseph. Drop it for a loss of 4 from his defensive tackle spot.
So this one's over. It's in the win column for the L.A. Chargers. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they plan to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So for the Chargers, that early momentum continues here as they move to 4-0. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.
Style, don't y'all? Nice like this, I wish I was.